Indian is making waves again, and oh boy are they pretty waves. The Challenger has been finally officially announced by Indian this week, and I say finally since photos have been floating around online for a good couple of months now. Now, Indian seems to be taking this teasing thing a bit too far, since the clip they released announcing their new engine gives you a glimpse at the new Challenger, but not much else. Let's take a look. Now let's talk a little about the new engine first before we move over to the bike, since Indian has managed to do something really special here. Now this is an all new 108 cubic inches, that's close to 1800 cc's for the rest of the world, liquid cooled V-twin engine. Now this is the first liquid cooled engine in Indian's lineup, and they claim it will be the highest performing American V-twin ever developed. You get 4 valves per cylinder on a single overhead cam which uses hydraulic lifters. Why should you care? Would be the first thing I would ask myself. Well, if you are a manly man and do the maintenance of your bike yourself, you no longer have to bother with those horrendous valve adjustments for the engine. Ever. And that is something to be happy about. Next up is performance. While the obvious competitor here, Harley Davidson, rarely likes to bring up horsepower numbers. Seriously here, if you go to their website, you will have a very difficult time finding out how powerful your brand new bike is. They post the torque numbers, but not the engine power. Probably something to do with, it's not about the power, it's about how you feel when you ride it. Well, Harley, some people would like to know how powerful their bike is, okay? So why don't you go ahead and add that there? But anyway, I digress. The Milwaukee 8107 engine, which is used in the 2020 Road Glide, puts out about 92 horsepower and 164 pound-feet of torque, while Yamaha's Eluder, another big competitor in this segment, only puts out 75 horsepower and 106 pound-feet of torque. In comparison, the new Indian PowerPlus engine wipes the floor with both of them, producing 128 pound-feet of torque and 122 horsepower, while allowing for revs as high as 6500 RPM. And thirdly, the engine also uses ride-by-wire technology, which means you will get separate riding modes on the new bike, helping you based on your skill, your preference, or the road conditions. Speaking of the new bike, the Challenger was leaked a good couple of months ago, and we managed to get some nice, if not blurry, photos out of it. But now, Indian seems to have leaked an official photo themselves. While introducing their 2020 Indian Scout lineup, a very happy Challenger sits in the background. Then some other public photos seem to have made their way online, and as of now, we have a pretty complete picture of the bike. It obviously looks production ready, and from the looks of it, it features a full LED headlamp with distinctive LED running light strips on the side of the fairing, making sure it will be recognizable from a mile away, a tall windscreen, and dual tone alloy wheels. You also get upside down forks with radially mounted Brembo brakes, and by the looks of it, a 19-inch front wheel. There are also hard panniers on the bike and a very wide fixed fairing, which is again similar to Harley's Road Glide. The American Indian head mascot is also illuminated on the front fender, taking you back to Indian's heritage. Everything we see in these images suggests that Indian want to focus on performance and handling, as well as looks, which is very important now more than ever, as European brands look to muscle in with high-tech offerings. BMW has already announced the 1800cc cruiser, which will probably be in US dealerships next year. The official release of the Challenger is scheduled for next week, and that's when we will get all the juicy details regarding undoubtedly India's next successful motorcycle. Let us know in the comments what you think of the new Challenger and how do you think Harley, for example, will respond to this. Is the current Road Glide enough to keep Indian away, or do they need to do more? A lot more. Well, that's the show, everybody. If you've enjoyed it, give it a big thumbs up, and if you think you've learned something new, consider subscribing or becoming one of our patrons to help us make more of these shows. Cheers, and I'll see you on the next one.